Hi, my name is Alice, and today I'll be talking about 50s rock and roll. Rock and roll, by definition, is a genre of popular music that originated and evolved in the United States during the late 1940s and early 1950s. It was a combination of African American genres such as blues, jump blues, jazz, and gospel music, together with Western swing and country music. Though elements of rock and roll can be heard in blues records from the early 1920s and in country records of the 1930s, it was not known as a specific genre until the baby boom teenagers in the 1950s made it mainstream. One of the most popular figures representing rock and roll culture in the 1950s was Buddy Holly. He was an American musician and singer-songwriter born September 7, 1936 in Lubbock, Texas during the Depression. Even from a young age, his passion for music was clear. His family valued music and he grew up playing guitar with his siblings. His style was influenced by gospel music, country music, rhythm, blues, and acts, and he performed in Lubbock with his friends from high school. He made his first appearance on local television in 1952 and toured with Elvis Presley by being his opening act in 1955. As a result of that, his band style shifted from country and western to entirely rock and roll. Later that year, he was spotted by a Nashville scout, Eddie Crandall, who got him a contract with Decca Records. However, he was unhappy with the record company as they tried to alter Holly's style of music. He went to Norman Petty in Clovis, New Mexico, and recorded a demo that made him well known to the public. That demo was sent to New Brunswick Records, and it was released as a single from The Crickets, which later became the name of Holly's band. In September of 1957, the band toured, and their demo topped US and UK singles chart. Following their success, they released another major hit in October called Peggy Sue. That is a song that is currently playing. While it is true that rock and roll is said to have been created from a group of people and not just one individual, Chuck Berry comes the closest to being the inventor of this popular genre of music. He was genius at grafting country and western guitar licks onto a rhythm and blues chassis. That is the reason for the tremendous amount of love and success following the release of his very first single, Maybelline, which is a song playing right now. Chuck Berry was born in St. Louis, Missouri on October 18, 1926 to a middle-class African-American family. Similar to Buddy Holly, Berry also developed an interest for music at a young age. He played music for his high school, but he was sentenced to prison for armed robbery. After he got released in 1947, he got married and worked at an automobile assembly plant, settling into an average normal life. That soon changed in 1953 when he rediscovered his interest for music as a direct result of the guitar riffs and showmanship techniques of T-Bone Walker. He then started performing as a band along with Johnny Johnson Trio. His break came when he traveled to Chicago in 1955 and met Muddy Waters, who suggested that he contact Trice Records. He did and recorded his first single and major hit, Maybelline. It sold over a million copies and reached number one on Billboard magazine's Rhythm and Blues chart. By the end of the 1950s, he was an established star with many hit records and often appeared on television. He even established his own nightclub called Berry's Club Bandstand. However, in January of 1962, he was sentenced to 3 years in prison for transporting a 14-year-old girl across state lines. This temporarily ended his music career, but after his release in 1963, he picked up where he left off and released many other successful songs. In the 1970s, he focused more on live performances rather than recorded songs, but he was still well-known and successful nonetheless. Rock and roll started out as primarily black music, and a lot of white families, especially Christian ones, were opposed to their children listening to it. Children, however, loved rock and roll and spent countless amounts of money to purchase records or see performers live in concert. Parents not only hated rock and roll because of the black influence, they also hated it because they thought it would cause their children to use drugs or have more sex. Some people even went as far as creating campaigns and strikes to ban radios for playing this music.